Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vancha kaupata rubhyascha kripa sindhu bhayevacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavibhyo namo namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So at this point in Brihad Bhagavatamrita, Uddhava had been sent to Vrindavan to meet the gopis by Lord Krishna and to deliver a message to them.
现在在大伯教大堂甘露之补书中就讲到了，嗯，就Krishna派遣Uddhava去Vrindavan去见那些宫嫔们，给他们捎信儿。So
he had never seen such pure devotees who were so surrendered before.
Uddhava在此之前从来没见过这么纯洁的、这么臣服的奉献者。And
before he left Vrindavan, he spoke some glorification of the gopis.
在离开本大门之前, Uddhava就讲述了, 对勾皮们的荣耀。
He describes that there are many people all desiring liberation, but there's none of them are greater than the gopis.
他形容说, 有许许多多的人都渴望解脱, 但是没有一个能像勾皮们那么光荣的，那么伟大。The
gopis are greater than all of the self-realized liberated saints.
勾皮们比那些自我觉悟了的人都要伟大得多。And
there are many devotees of Krishna, but the gopis are the greatest.
就Krishna有许许多多的奉献者，其中勾皮们是最了不起的奉献者。And
these gopis are actually all goddesses of fortune who have come to reside in the village of Nanda Maharaj.
这些勾皮们其实都是幸运女神，她们前来居住在Nanda大君的村子。
They've taken birth in a cowherd village, a village where the cows are taken care of. But these ladies have understood the real value of the human life.
然而这些女士们 理解生命的真正价值所在。
So they're the greatest of all the devotees.
因此他们是最了不起、最伟大的奉献者。
And the of all people residing on earth, they're the best.
在地球上居住的人们当中，勾皮们是最优秀的人。
On higher planets like heaven, where Indra resides, the people in the heavenly planets have a lot of power and they have a lot of sense gratification.
在主、Indra居住的天堂，那里的人，那里的拜神人们拥有很多的力量，但是他们也进行很多的感官享乐。
So, they cannot develop the same love for Krishna. It's impossible for them to develop the love of the gopis.
可能像勾皮们那样发展出对主 Krishna 那样的厚爱之情。
So the demigods and even great sages who live in the higher planets, they cannot perfect their life like the gopis.
半神人们以及在高等星宿居住的圣哲们，他们不能够像勾皮们达到那样的完美境界。
So the gopis have a very special gift, which is prema bhakti, pure love for Krishna. Quality they can deliver all the conditioned souls on the earth planet.
通过这项品质，勾皮们能够拯救地球上的所有受条件限制的灵魂。
So all the people on the earth planet, they get great benefit just by the, from the gopis.
地球上的人们都由于勾皮们而得到了巨大的好处。
The gopis are full of wonderful qualities, like they have very natural compassion.
勾皮们拥有许许多多美好的品质，比如说他们心中自然而然地流露出怜悯之情。
Because they have these, all of these wonderful qualities which they have are very good for other people. And then the gopis have that love in their hearts for the son of Nanda Maharaj.
你们心中怀着对 Nanda Maharaj 的儿子的巨大的奉爱。
Nanda Maharaj is the king of the cowherds, and Krishna is the son of the king of the cowherds.
Nanda 大君是牧牛郎的国王，而 Krishna 是牧牛郎国王的儿子。
And Krishna is famous as Govinda because he is the Indra of the cows.
Krishna 以狗温德而著称，因为他是母牛的国王。
Indra means king, so Krishna is like the king of over all the cows.
Indra 的字面意思是国王，所以主 Krishna 就相当于母牛的国王。
So the gopis, they forget, they don't care about anything else except.Their love for Krishna, love for Govinda.
Gopis 们，他们对所有其他都不在意，他们心中只有对 Govinda 的爱。
Krishna is actually their lover. They enjoy loving relationships with him.
Krishna 实际上是他们的情人。Gopis 们享受着跟 Krishna 之间的爱的关系。
Just like they enjoyed the Rasa Lila festival with Krishna.
比如说，他们会跟 Krishna 享受 Rasa 之舞的节日。
And then they showed also their love for Krishna in separation from Krishna.
Gopis 们还展示了。在与 Krishna 的爱的分离之中的爱。
The gopis took away Uddhava's wisdom. Uddhava is very learned, very great soul because he was a disciple of Brihaspati, who was the guru of the demigods. But the gopis, they took away.All of his wisdom.
Uddhava 是半神人们的祭司 Brihaspati 的门生，他非常博学，非常有知识。但是 Gopi 们把 Uddhava 的智慧也拿走了。
The Gopis had just they had tolerated the pain of separation from Krishna. In their hearts, they felt that pain of separation from Krishna.But they tolerated it.
Gopis 们内心 怀着对 Krishna 的分离之苦，但是 Gopi 们容忍了这些分离之情。
But when Uddhava came there with his message and he read the message to the Gopis, then they could not hold their, they could not restrain themselves, they could not stop themselves.
当乌德瓦来文达文给 Gopi 们朗读 Krishna 的信息的时候，这些 Gopi 们这时候已经无法抑制自己了。
And Uddhava witnessed, he saw the Gopis and he saw the distress which they were in, and how they could not control themselves.
这时候乌德瓦就亲眼目睹了 Gopi 们内心的巨大的痛苦，这时候 Gopi 们已经无法克制自己了。
Oh, this distress, this is actually the ecstasy of the Gopis, which they feel in separation from Krishna.
这些苦恼实际上是 Gopi 们感受到跟 Krishna 分离之情的时候 Gopi 们内心的狂喜。
And this pain of separation causes the whole world to cry.
这种分离之情使得整个世界都哭泣了起来。
Because everyone will feel sympathy for the gopis.
因为所有人都对 gopi 们怀着巨大的怜悯。
And this feeling which the gopis felt, it brings the devotees to the...almost to the point of death.
这种对 Gopi 们的怜悯之情使得奉献者们几乎就濒临死亡了。
So, Lord Krishna is the soul of all beings.
主 Krishna 是众生的灵魂。
But he is...We also have to understand that each gopi loves him as her very life and soul.
但是我们必须明白，每一位 gopi 们热爱 Krishna， 都像爱自己的生命和灵魂。
And other devotees, they cannot begin to imitate the feeling which the gopis have for Krishna.
而其他的奉献者们甚至都无法开始模仿 Gopi 们的奉爱之情。
Nobody can love Krishna in the manner which the Gopis do.
没有人能够像 Gopi 们爱 Krishna 那样的来爱 Krishna.
So some people are trying to get liberation.And they're very afraid of the material existence.
有些人试图寻求解脱，因为他们恐惧物质存在。
And there are devotees of the Lord who are satisfied in the self.
还有主的奉献者们，他们对于自我已经心满意足了。
They're liberated souls.And they don't fear the material existence.
因为他们已经是解脱了的灵魂，所以他们并不害怕物质存在。
So both these kind of people, right? They're both great souls. They both understand Krishna to be the supreme goal.
这两类人，他们 Krishna 也是灵性努力的。至高无上的果实。
So those who are liberated and others who are trying for liberation, they have the good fortune to get the mercy of the Vaishnavas.
那些已经解脱了的奉献者，以及那些正在寻求解脱了的人们，他们都有着巨大的好运。能够得到 Vaishnava 的仁慈。
Not just any Vaishnavas, but the Vaishnavas who appreciate the love the gopis have for Krishna.
这里 里的 Vaishnava 并不是指的任何 一种 Vaishnava， 而是那些仰慕 Gopi 们对 Krishna 的父爱之情的 Vaishnava。
But it's very very rare to get this association。
但是得到这种联谊是非常非常罕见的。
So Uddhava thinks he's in that category, he's in that condition, position。
Uddhava 就把自己归于这一类范畴，他认为自己就处在这种地位上。
He's a sincere servant of Krishna and he can only admire the gopis' love for Krishna。
他是 Krishna 真诚的仆人，他只能羡慕 gopis 们对 Krishna 的爱。
But he can only appreciate the gopis from a distance, he cannot get too close。
Uddhava 只能远远的在远处来欣赏 Gopi 们的爱，他不能靠近。
So somebody may question, they say, well, isn't Lord Brahma greater than the Gopis? Isn't Lord Brahma the greatest Vaishnava?
有的人会提出这种疑问，难道主 Brahma 不是最了不起的、最伟大的 Vaishnava 吗？
Brahma is the original guru in devotional service. He's the first guru.
在奉爱服务当中 ，Brahma 是最原初的 guru.
Brahma must be greater than all those people who are trying to get liberation.
Brahma 一定比那些努力寻求解脱的人们更伟大。
And he's even greater than all the liberated devotees.
而且他比那些已经解脱了的奉献者更伟大。
He's on the top of the universe. He's like the king, the ruler of the universe.
他处在宇宙的最高的星球，他几乎就相当他是宇宙的国王。
And he has so many good qualities.
他拥有这么多美妙的品质。
If the gopis are so special, if they're so great, why didn't they accept birth like him?
如果 gopi 们这么伟大，这么崇高，为什么没有投生为像 Brahma 那种地位呢？
Then they will be worshipped. The whole world will worship them.
如果那样的话，他们就会得到全世界的崇拜了。
But instead, they come to earth and they take birth in the cowherd village, so they're not high class. This is a low class position.
相反，他们投生在地球，投生在牧牛郎的村庄，这种出生并不是一种很高级的出生。
So Uddhava has to answer this question.
Uddhava 必须回答这个疑惑。
And he has to speak about the position of the Supreme Lord Krishna and Balaram.
他必须要讲述至尊主 Krishna 和 Balarama 的地位。
And he has to explain about special devotees who are called Rasika Bhaktas. It means they have a taste for hearing.About the pastimes of Krishna and Balaram.
Uddhava 必须要描述 Rasika Bhakta 的地位。这些奉献者们对于聆听至尊主的消时光非常有品味。
So these devotees, they have no interest in being born as Brahma. Even to take birth as Brahma many times doesn't mean anything to them.
这些奉献者们对投生为主 Brahma 并不感兴趣，即便是可以许多次的投生为主 Brahma。
They think taking birth as Brahma will be an obstacle to their devotion。
他们认为投生为主 Brahma 对他们做奉爱服务反而是一个障碍。
They won't be able to hear all the pastimes of the Lord so intensely。
他们就不能有那 强烈的品味来聆听主的逍遥时光呢？
The problem is you take birth as Brahma, then it creates things like pride, because you have a big position in the universe, so you become proud.
同时为 Brahma 的一个问题就是有这样崇高的地位他就会变得骄傲。
So the gopis, they want to taste the honey found at the lotus feet of Krishna.
勾皮们他们希望能够品味在狗温的莲花足下能够找到的甘露。
So they prefer to be born as simple daughters of the cowherd people.
因此他们宁愿投生为普通的投生为那些牧牛郎的女儿们。
That's better than taking a big birth as Lord Brahma.
这种投生比起投生为主 Brahma 这样了不起的地位更加伟大。
So if somebody has no interest to hear the topics of Krishna, then what can he won't get any benefit by taking birth, even as Brahma.
如果某人对于聆听 Krishna 的话题不感兴趣的话，那么投身为宇宙的创造者 Brahma 这样的地位又有什么用呢？
We have to develop this attraction, this taste, to hear all the topics of the Lord.
We 必须要对于聆听主的话题，深深的吸引。
That is the real fruit of renunciation.
那是气绝的真正的果实。
And all, that's the fruit of devotional practice.
那是奉爱修习的果实。
So if a devotee doesn't have this taste for hearing, then he cannot be called a liberated person. He cannot be called a renunciate or even a Vaishnava.
那些缺乏这种品味的人们不能被称为是解脱了的人，也不能称为是一个弃绝者，不能被称为是一个奉献者万事那瓦。
So Uddhava is explaining that the gopis were thinking on the highest level of self-realization.
Uddhava 就想着这些勾品们是处在自我觉悟的最高层面上的。
So they gave up all the normal behavior of civilized people.
所以他们放弃了那些文明人的正常的行为举止。
And they even gave up the principles of the Dharma taught in the Vedas.
甚至放弃了伟达经所教授的宗教的原则。
The gopis, or any person who has a taste for the topics of Krishna, then.The Vedic knowledge is not as important as hearing Krishna Katha.
那些对于聆听主的话题，感兴趣的有品味的人们，那就像勾品们，他们对于伟达的知识并不感兴趣。
Yeah, you may hear Vedic knowledge, but it's not as important as hearing Krishna Katha.
一个人也许会聆听到伟达的知识， 但聆听伟达知识并不比聆听 Krishna Katha 更加重要。
So a person who has understood the topics of Lord Krishna has nothing to gain by Vedic study.
那些对于聆听 Krishna 的话题感兴趣的人们，他们从研习韦达经中得不到什么益处。
He doesn't gain anything by hearing that he is a spirit different from matter.
从聆听，他是灵魂跟物质有分别的灵魂这个话题呢，他从中得不到什么，他从中没有什么收获。
So, if a person doesn't take an interest in hearing the topics of Krishna,then Vedic study is useless.
如果一个人对聆听 Krishna 的话题不感兴趣的话，那么聆听伟达经是没有用处的。
And just to know about the self is also no value.
仅仅是了解自我也没有什么实质性的价值。
The only good thing which you could get from studying the Vedas is to become interested to hear about Krishna.
聆听韦达经，学习韦达经的唯一的好处是能够去聆听到有关 Krishna 的话题。
People inquire about who are they to understand the self and Vedic study.Self-realization. So they're meant to bring people to the fight to the goal. The real goal is to hear about Krishna.
人们探寻有关于自我的身份，他们去研习韦达经，他们去努力觉悟自我，但这一切真正的目标是达到最终极的目标，那就是去聆听有关 Krishna.
So when we come to that stage of being eager to hear about Krishna, then you don't have to worry about the other things. You can forget about.
如果我们已经一个人达到了这样的目标，去渴望聆听 Krishna， 达到这样的境界，那么其他种种的他都可以忘记了，放在一边。
Just like a person may light a lamp, maybe he wants to find something in his room, but it's very dark, so he lights a lamp to find it.
就比方说一个人他在一片漆黑的房间当中呢，他想找东西，他就点燃了一盏灯。
So once he finds the thing he's looking for, then he can put out the lamp,And then he can go to sleep.
一旦他找到了他想寻找到的物品的话，他就可以熄灭这盏灯，然后就去睡觉了。
Or a person may want to take a boat to cross the river.
或者是一个人他乘船要渡河。
So.He can forget about the boat. After he crosses the river, then he can forget about the boat. He doesn't have to worry about the boat.
一旦他渡到了河对岸的话，他就可以忘记这条船了。
But a person who never reaches the goal, he can just remain stubborn and attached to.The process.
但是还没有真达那个目标的人们，一个人，他就会顽固的依附这些程序。
Just like if you try to beat the husks of grains, you don't get anything.
就好像一个人去击打空稻谷壳的话。
It's just a waste of time. useless.
那是浪费时间，是无用的，无劳的。
So a devotee who has a taste for hearing the topics of Krishna, he is the best person.
一个对聆听有关 Krishna 话题感兴趣的人是最优秀的人。
Even he may not practice the principles of Bhakti Yoga.
即便他没有去练习 Bhakti 瑜伽的原则。
But he can never give up hearing and chanting about Krishna.
他就永远无法放弃聆听唱诵 Krishna.
And he wants to always encourage the opportunities to hear and chant more.
而且他总是渴望有机会更多的聆听，更多的去唱诵。
So the gopis are the most fortunate of all women.
公平们是最幸运的女人了。
And they have that very rare quality of love for Krishna.
他们拥有这个最稀罕的爱狗瘟的品质。
So all the ordinary standards of the Vedic culture are of no value for the gopis.
所以普通的去理解伟大经，这个对高品们来说是没有价值的。
And even somebody may be doing meditation, that's very dry, and that's also selfish. It's only for our own personal benefit, so it has no real value.
而倘若某人只是在那里一味冥想的话，那是非常枯燥无味的，而且也是自私的，没有什么真正的价值。
So it's amazing that these cowherd women, very simple women, they can wander about the forest. And it's like they've spoiled. Their behavior seems not proper.
那么这些女士们，她们在森林当中漫游，这是多么令人惊讶的景象啊！这个景象就好像他们的行为举止并不是很端正。
But these ladies have achieved the perfection of pure love for Krishna.
然而这些女士们是已经达到了对 Krishna 的爱的完美境界了。
And Krishna gives his blessings even to an ignorant worshipper.
愚昧的崇拜者，Krishna也会祝福这样的崇拜者。
Just like a person may be ignorant about a medicine, he doesn't know about any what are the ingredients in the medicine, but when he takes the medicine works.
正如一个人对于药效是一无所知，他如果吃了这个药的话，这个药也会发生药效。
So Uddhava spoke like this. He considered himself unqualified to have the company of the gopis.
Uddhava 就说出这番言语，他认为自己没有资格得到高品们的陪伴。
And he understands it's only by the mercy of Krishna that he had the opportunity to associate with the gopis.
他知道，仅仅是由于 Krishna 的仁慈，他才能得到 Gopi 们的联谊。
So Uddhava compares himself to the Gopis, and he thinks that the Gopis, they are the best devotees.
Uddhava 把自己和 Gopi 们进行了一番比较，他认为 Gopi 们是最优秀的奉献者。
And he understands. Uddhava understands.That he has deviated in many ways from the path of devotion.
Uddhava 明白他自己
Uddhava thinks he committed many serious offenses. Sometimes he would refuse to carry out Krishna's instructions. And sometimes he had no confidence in bhakti yoga. So Uddhava knows that compared to the gopis, he is fallen. The gopis, they like to roam in the forest. That is due to their love for Krishna. It causes them to go and wander in the forest. Because when they go in the forest, they remember so many of the pastimes which took place there. So when they're in the pain of separation from Krishna, they will go to the most secluded part of the forest. And they will wander about there, where it's just forests, it's just nothing, wilderness. So the goddesses of fortune, who are all gopis in the village of Nanda Maharaj, they're like that. They're helpless. They're helpless because of their love for Krishna. They have so much love for Krishna. Uddhava's life is nothing like the gopis. Uddhava's a male, and he lives in the city, a busy city. And he has a nice residence, he has a nice home, and he enjoys all the comforts. He doesn't wander around the Vrindavan forest. And he's proud of knowing about Krishna. He understands philosophically who is Krishna. So he cannot get the treasure which the gopis have, which is love for Krishna. So Uddhava understands, compared to the gopis, he's a very fallen soul. But the gopis, they have unlimited good qualities. And Uddhava thinks he will never be worthy of their association. So Uddhava, He got some honor because he had that little association with the gopis of Vrindavan.
因为乌德瓦和文达文的狗皮们有了些许的联谊，所以他也同样获得了一些荣誉。
And because when he was speaking on behalf of Narada and Akrura,
因为他在代表 Narada 和 Akrura 说话。
So Uddhava feels, when he talks about the gopis, he doesn't speak directly, he just simply calls, he says, these ladies, these women. He doesn't say the gopis particularly, but he just refers to them as these women. Because he has so much awe, he feels so much awe and respect for them in their presence.
乌德瓦说话的时候，他并没有指名道姓的而提到这些勾皮们，他只是把他们称之为这些女人们。嗯，因为他在他们面前，他怀着深厚的敬畏之情。
So it's only in the hearts of the gopis that we can find that pure love for Krishna.
只有在勾皮们的心中才能找到对 Krishna 的纯洁之爱。
And it's only by the power of devotional service to Krishna that a foolish person such as Uddhava could have the good fortune to see the position of the gopis.
只有急着对 Krishna 的奉爱奉献服务这种特殊的力量，像乌达瓦认为他自己这样的愚蠢之人才有特权能够目睹勾皮们的荣耀。
Krishna is the independent supreme controller.
Krishna 是独立自主的至高无上的控制者。
And he will give suitable rewards for any service which we do for him.
无论我们为他做什么服务 ，Krishna 都会给予他认为合适的报答。
And he reciprocates with the devotees in whichever way he likes.
他会以他所喜欢的方式来跟奉献者们互动交流。
Somebody may be very ignorant and may not know about Krishna's greatness or the greatness of these devotees.
有些愚昧的人可能对于 Krishna 的伟大以及他的奉献者的伟大一无所知。
But Krishna may give his kindness on that person. He may give a lot of special mercy to that person.
但是 Krishna 可能对这样的人展示出许多的仁慈，许多的仁慈。
Even the person, he may see devotees,And he may see devotional services just being material.
He sees
devotees and devotional service just to be material.
即便有的人认为奉献者或者是奉献服务是物质的。
But because the person somehow he did a little service.To one of the devotees, so he gets the mercy of Krishna.
即便是一个这样的一个人对 Krishna 或他的奉献者做出了贬低的服务，他也会得到 Krishna 的仁慈。
So anybody who approaches Krishna's devotees and just does takes a little step to do service to Krishna, then Krishna immediately.She takes an interest in them and gives blessings.
即便一个人仅仅是向 Krishna 朝着 Krishna 奉献者迈出了一小步，对他做了一点点服务 ，Krishna 也会对这样的人展示出许许多多的兴趣。
Yeah, the good example is just like when you're sick, if you take a powerful medicine, so you don't know anything about the properties of the medicine. and you don't know the ingredients, but the medicine helps you get you cured.
这个例子就好像一个对于这个一个生病很重的人，他对于他所要吃下的药的成分并不了解，但是他如果吃下了这剂强有力的药的话，他的疾病就能得到治愈。
So Krishna's mercy acts on anybody who comes in touch with him.
Krishna 的仁慈会在任何和他接触的人身上发生作用。
So whatever Krishna wants to do, he can do.
无论 Krishna 想做什么，他都可以随心所欲。
And if he doesn't want to do something, nobody can get him to do it.
如果 Krishna 不想做什么事情的话，没有人能够让他做到。
So, if he wants, he can undo any situation.To change it to whatever he prefers.
如果 Krishna 有意向的话，他可以扭转一个局势，变成他所喜欢的局面。
And he has such powerful energies that he can fulfill all his desires.
Krishna 拥有全面有力量的能量，他因此他可以满足他的心愿。
So he can give the highest perfection of life to anyone.
因此他可以把生命的最完美、最高的境界赐予任何人。
He may give it to somebody who is very wise, saint, who worships him constantly, without deviation.
他可以赐予那些毫不偏离的、恒常的崇拜他的智慧的圣人。
But he may also give it to someone who just worships him irregularly.
另一方面，他也可以把，也可以赐予那些并不是很有规律的崇拜他的人们。
But Krishna may also give it to someone who never worships him, but somehow he has some good fortune.
而且 Krishna 也可以赐予那些从来没有崇拜过他的人，但是这样的人是特别幸运的人。
Yeah, because the good fortune was that he had somehow came in touch, he had contact with the devotees.
这样的人的好运在于他无论如何，他跟 Krishna 的奉献者发生了联系。
So Krishna can give his mercy immediately. He doesn't have to wait.
Krishna 可以立刻就赐予仁慈，他不用等待。
And he can give that mercy. It can be seen by everyone, not just a few people.
他也可以让他的仁慈，任何人都可以看见他的仁慈，而不是仅仅几个人才能看见他的仁慈。
Krishna can make it so obvious that we don't have to search it. We don't have to do speculation, study knowledge. We can see it very clearly.
而且 Krishna 也可以让他的仁慈清晰可见，不需要我们去进行心智推敲或者去进行哲学方面的探索。他的仁慈是清晰可见的。
Just like you get some medicines which are so powerful, which are so rare, that even you don't taste it, you don't put it in your mouth, you just simply smell it, and the medicine takes effect.
就像有些药物，它的药效是这么强大，即便是一个人他并没有服下这剂药物，他仅仅是用鼻子闻了这个药物的发出的气味，他就可以得到。
So, when Lord Krishna was dancing with the gopis in Rasa Lila, the gopis were all embraced by Lord Krishna's arms.
当 gopi 们在 Rasa 之舞中跟 Krishna 共舞的时候，他们被 Krishna 臂膀所拥抱着。
The goddesses of fortune, they never got that opportunity.
幸运女神也许永远得不到这样的好，这样的仁慈。
And other consorts in the spiritual world also, they never had that opportunity.
而在灵性世界的其他的伴侣们，他们也没有得到这样的好运。
And they say the ladies in the heavenly planets, they're the most beautiful, and they have their bodily luster and aroma is so attractive, but they never got that opportunity to be with Krishna.
据说天堂上的女人们，她们是如此的美丽，她们身体散发出光芒。 散发出各种香气，但是这些天堂上的女人们也没有能够得到这样的机会。So
women on this planet also may be very beautiful, but by mundane estimation, they have no hope to get the same opportunity of the gopis.
所以在这个地球上的，在地球上的人的眼里看来，那些美女们，她们也得不到这样的机会。
So Uddhava was astonished about all of this. It was astonishing to him, because Mahalakshmi is the consort of Lord Narayan.
Uddhava 对此感到非常的震惊，因为Mahalakshmi是主Narayan的伴侣。
Now, so she's famous because she's the beloved of Lord Narayan, but she cannot enjoy the Lord's favor the way the gopis of Vrindavan did.
Mahalakshmi是因为是主Narayan的伴侣而闻名遐迩，但是她不能享受到Vrindavan的gopis们。 得到主的仁慈，但是这些马哈拉克什密是跟他们，勾引们无法媲美的。
So other people, if the goddess of fortune has no opportunity, then other people also have no hope.
如果连幸运女神都没有机会的话，那么其他人也就没有指望了。The
gopis of Vrindavan. They gave up the association of their husbands and their sons and their family members. It's very difficult to give up the association of our dear family. And the gopis also gave up their chastity to take shelter of the lotus feet of Mukunda, Krishna. So Uddhava prays that I should be fortunate if I'm able to take birth as one of the bushes or creepers or herbs in Vrindavan. Because I know the gopis will walk there and then I'll get the dust from their lotus feet.
因为勾品们会从旁边经过，这样我就能得到他们莲花族上的尘土。So
Uddhava had seen, he'd personally witnessed the nature of the behavior of the gopis.
Uddhava 他亲眼目睹了勾品们的本性。And
he's describing their glories in his own words.
他现在就以自己的话描述着勾品们的荣耀。So
Uddhava, he's also become absorbed in that mood of the gopis.
Uddhava, 他现在也 完全专注于勾品们的心态当中。
A very special mood in loving Krishna in that mood.
这是一种对 Krishna 的爱的特殊的心绪。
So he's, Uddhava now knows his, the real desire of his heart.
Uddhava 现在对自己内心真正的渴望有所了解了。
So he prays that it, the fruit of all of his service that he has done for Krishna is that in next birth, he will take birth in Vrindavan.
So Uddhava 就祈祷如果 他为 Krishna 所做的服务他得到什么成果的话那么在来世他希望投生于 Vrindavan
But he prays that he will take birth as a plant in Vrindavan to get the dust of the gopis
但是 Uddhava 祈祷他能够投生为 Vrindavan 的 一个植物好得到 gopi 们梅花族的尘土
So Uddhava is very enthusiastic to achieve this.
Uddhava 对取得这样的目标是满腔热情的。
So he's inspired to speak more about the gopis.
他现在就被激励着说出更多的有关荣耀，对 gopi 们进行更多的荣耀。
So he was describing how the gopis gave up.Their husbands and their children and their family, and even the Vedic culture, they gave it all up for Krishna.
为了 Krishna 的缘故，这些勾品们，他们放弃了丈夫、孩子、亲朋好友，甚至放弃了伟大的行为举止原则。
The things which we usually, the things which ordinary people think to be very valuable.They gave them up.
普通人视为十分珍贵的事物，这些勾品们都一并加以放弃了。
And they gave them all up so they could devote themselves fully to Krishna.
勾品们将他们一并放弃了，好让自己全然的奉献于主 Krishna。
Every day the gopis eagerly go out in the morning and the evening to see the path which Krishna will use to go to the forest.
每天清晨和每天傍晚时分，这些 gopi 们都目不转睛地望着 Krishna, 通向森林去森林的道路。
So in that sense, the gopis, they could see Krishna go out in the morning and they could see him also come home in the evening.
Gopi 们就这样可以在清晨和傍晚时分可以看着 Krishna 去森林和返回到自己的家中。
So that path, we can also think that's like the path of Bhakti Yoga.
这条道路呢我们可以视为是奉爱瑜伽的道路。
The gopis gave up their family so they could do service to Krishna.
Gopi 们放弃了他们的家人，好为 Krishna 做服务。
Of course, the gopis they didn't expect to get Krishna.
当然，gopi 们并不指望着得到 Krishna。
So their surrender is very special, and we have to appreciate how wonderful their service is.
他们的臣服是非常罕见、独一无二的，所以我们应该欣赏他们的臣服。
But why have these gopis? Why have these gopis given up the life of dedication to their husbands and families?
为什么这些勾品们，他们 他们过着那个放弃他们的丈夫和他们的家人的这种生活呢？
They've set a bad example for others by doing this.
他们这么做可是为其他人树立了一个不良的榜样啊。
And they've gone against the teachings of the Vedas by doing that.
这么做也是违背了韦达经的权威啊。
But Uddhava understands that the Vedas consider devotional service to Krishna to be the goal of life.
但是 Uddhava 说，连韦达经自己都认为对 Krishna 的奉献服务是生命的目标所在。
The Vedas can only help us to come to prema. Of the go to come to that prem of the gopis.
韦达经只能帮助我们接近，这种 prema， 这种 gopi 们的爱。
But the Vedas itself doesn't help us to achieve prema.
但是韦达经自身并没有获得了这个目标。
So the Vedas teach us the principles of religion and spiritual knowledge.
韦达经教导了宗教原则，教导了灵性知识。
But the path the gopis took by giving up the Vedic knowledge is not wrong.
但是 gopi 们他们所踏上的这条放弃韦达经的道路，这并没有什么错误。
Because they gave it up for the sake of the most valuable thing. Something which we cannot get from the Vedas. So for the gopis to observe the religious principles,that would only prevent the gopis from properly worshipping Krishna.
所以 gopi 们遵从韦达原则的话，就会阻止他们恰当的崇拜 Krishna 莲花族。
And their dealings with their families and their husbands and all these things, it will stop the gopis from worshipping the feet of Krishna.
他们和家庭成员的交往会阻止他们对 Krishna 的崇拜。
Okay, so we stop here today.
好，那我们今天的正课部分讲到这里，接下来我们看一下问题。第一个问题 ，Shruti Rupa Devadasi Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru， 就是身边的一个奉献者，想通过我向 Guru 表达的忏悔。前段时间，因为他还想在物质方面出人头地，每天和社会各种人群打交道，结果16圈念诵都完成不了，灵性生活几乎就被毁灭了。后来发现，无论在物质方面怎样用心努力，也不可能交到真心的朋友，更不可能找到真正的快乐，于是赶紧补上了欠下的圈数和功课。现在真诚地请教 Guru， 您是否会宽恕这个知错而改的孩子，并且给他一个信誓呢？另外，他昨天一天就像渴望学习奉爱知识的新人，免费发了30多本书，心中感受到前所未有的欢喜。他想请教 Guru， 怎样可以在平凡的生活中保持这种灵性的快乐和进步呢？感恩 Guru。Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru. So this is another devotee want to express her or his sorrowfulness in her heart through me. In the previous period, because she want to be prominent in the society. Therefore, she deals with various people in the society, and she couldn't finish her 16 rounds, and her spiritual life almost finished. But later on, she found out that no matter how she endeavors, she cannot get genuine friend, and also she cannot find the genuine happiness. Therefore, she catch up with her rounds and her practice. Now she very sincerely want to inquire from Guru, can you forgive this child who has known her mistake and try to correct them? And also, can you give her some instructions?
Yes, of course, we can forgive her. And we request her to just take up again the process of devotional service and to begin hearing and chanting and associating with the devotees. And she has to chant, and she should make up for all the chanting which she didn't do. Try to do more chanting.
是的，我们可以原谅他。我们请求他再次开始这条公爱服务的道路，聆听、念诵和奉献者联谊，并且弥补他所落下的缺数，没有念的缺数，并且更多的来念诵。
And try to spend more time with the devotees.
努力地去和奉献者们，花更多的时间和奉献者们在一起。
And do service for the devotees.
还要为奉献者服务。
Help them in cleaning, in cooking.
帮助奉献者们清扫清洁，还有在烹饪方面，在打扫卫生方面协助奉献者。
And in this way, the devotees will all bless you.
以这种方式呢，奉献者们都会祝福这个人，这个奉献者。
When the gopis bless you, when the devotees bless you, then you will make great spiritual advancement.
一旦得到了奉献者的祝福，那么就会取得巨大的灵性进步了。
Okay.
And besides that, just for yesterday, she freely distributed more than 30 books to new fighters who want to get spiritual, who want to learn bhakti knowledge. Wow. And in this way, she felt happiness in her heart. That is, she hasn't felt so much happiness in her heart, and she want to inquire for Guru, how can she keep this spiritual happiness and spiritual progress in her ordinary life? Thank you, Guru.
Well, when she gives Krishna consciousness to others, that is the greatest happiness.
如果她能够把 Krishna 直觉给予其他人的话，这就是她最大的幸福和快乐。
So if she can continue to give Krishna, maybe in the form of books, also the holy name, prasadam, then it's very, very pleasing to the heart.
如果她继续地给予别人 Krishna, 是以给予书籍、给予圣名、给予 prasadam 的形式把 Krishna 给予别人的话，
那么就会令他的内心非常非常的快乐和喜悦。Yeah. Okay.
下一个问题。Mm-hmm. Okay. Inna, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and dear devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. First, in chapter 16 of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes the demonic nature in detail and also describes how we ourselves cannot become demons, but he does not say how to confront demons in the material world, how to defend ourselves against them. Demons consider their enemies, all those who are on the spiritual path and want to destroy them. If their aggression is directed at us, how do we resist them? OK， 这个问题是 Yuna 提的。那 Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj 和奉献者们，请接受我卑微的顶拜。所有荣耀归于Srila Prabhupada。在《薄伽梵歌》的第十六章 ，Krishna 详尽的描述了恶魔品质，以及描述了我们自己如何避免成为恶魔。但是 Krishna 并没有说，在物质世界如何来面对这些恶魔，如何在他们面前自卫。恶魔们把那些在灵性之途上的人们都视为是敌人，想要摧毁这些人们。如果他们这些恶魔们对我们就是气势汹汹的话，那么我们怎么能抵御他们呢？
Well, the best thing to do is to not get too close to them.
最好的方法就是不要离他们太近。
We don't associate with these kind of people.
我们不和这类人们联谊。
They may give you trouble, just tolerate.
他们也许给您找麻烦，那只能去容忍忍耐。
We should think that I must have given them trouble previously, so they're repaying me.
你应该这样想，我以前一定是给他们带来了麻烦，所以呢，他们现在以这种方式在报复。
But if you try to give them instruction, it will make things worse.
另一方面，如果你试图来教导他们的话，只能使情况更糟糕。
So the best thing is to try to be tolerant and just keep a distance from them.
最好的呢，就是不要离他们太近，而且跟他们保持距离。
You try to do, if they do something to you, don't try to get revenge on them.
如果他们试图对你采取一些行动的话，或者他们试图做一些什么事情，那你不要报复他们。
That, you know, there's a saying, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth.
有一句成语叫以牙还牙，以眼还眼。
So people think, oh, they did bad to me, I'm going to do bad to them.
人们就想啊，他对我行为这么恶劣，我也要对他行为很更差。
But that's not the thinking of devotee.
这个并不是奉献者的思维方式。
A devotee will tolerate.
奉献者们他们忍耐。
Because if somebody knocks out your eye, are you going to knock out their eye?
因为如果有人试图抠出你的眼睛，然后你又试图把他的眼睛挖出来的话，
then before we know it, the whole world.Nobody will have any eyes.
那么就在我们那个知道之前，那整个世界上的人们都没眼睛了。
So we have to learn to tolerate.
我们必须要学习怎么去忍耐、忍受。
And be happy that you have Krishna to associate with.
因为你能够和 Krishna 联谊而感到满足。
You have the holy name.
您有圣名。
You have devotional service.
您已经拥有了奉爱服务了。
So don't get involved in any arguments.
不要卷入任何的争执。
Just tolerate.
下一个 ，continue. Second question. In the lecture, you said that Uddhava was deviating from the path of devotion and committing offenses. Could you explain in more detail what were these deviations and offenses? 在讲课当中，您说 Uddhava 偏离了奉爱之途，做出了冒犯。您能不能具体的来解释一下？啊，这是哪些体现在哪些偏离和哪些冒犯呢？
Well, just like from the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, he gives so many instructions to Arjuna. So these instructions are also there for other people.
就如在佛教梵歌当中，主 Krishna 给了 Arjuna 许多的教导，所以这些训示也是同样给予其他人。
We should have full faith in devotional service.
我们应该对奉爱服务满怀信心。
So, sometimes we don't have full faith. And even Uddhava said sometimes he didn't have full faith.
有的时候我们就没有满怀信心，有的时候甚至乌德瓦对此也没有满怀信心。
And Krishna speaks about devotion. It's only by devotion that he can be understood. But Uddhava went to study philosophy and became a student of Brihaspati.
Krishna 说只有透过奉爱才能了解他，而Uddhava 呢，他对于哲学方面是很精到的，他成为了 Brihaspati 的学生。
We don't know what exactly, if Uddhava did actually commit these offenses, it may just be that he's being very humble. But we don't know from this, I don't know any from the scriptures, I don't know any details about how Krishna disobeyed Krishna's instructions.
但是我并不知道经典当中描述了哪些细节，就是Uddhava违背了主 Krishna 的训示。
It's the nature of very advanced devotees that they always speak that I'm very fallen, I'm very offensive.
进步的奉献者的本性呢，他们就会这种谦卑的表达，说我是非常堕落的，我是做了冒犯的。
But actually they're very great devotees and they never did anything offensive.
实际上他们都是伟大的奉献者，他们从来没有做过任何冒犯。
OK, 下一个问题。
下一个。Vishakha, Yuvati Vishakha, 顶拜古的莲花族新人问题，达摩达尔月最后五天戒食五谷对灵修有什么帮助呢？Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet, this question is raised by a newbie who asked, in the last 5 days of Kartika month, if we fast from rains, what's the benefit, what's the help for our spiritual practice?
Well, the benefit is that you have more time to chant.
那这个对我们的好处和帮助就是说我们有更多的时间念诵时间更多了。
And you have more energy to hear and do service for Krishna.
你也有了更多的能量来聆听 Krishna, 来服务 Krishna.
When we eat grains, then it's heavy and it makes us tired and we don't do so much work.
即使五谷是使会使一个人就是感到很难以消化，感到疲劳，就不能有很多很大的精力来做事儿。
And it also helps us to become more determined by controlling our tongue.
这也能帮助我们更有决心，因为我们控制了舌头。
Because we eat more than we need.We eat more than we need to eat.
Yes, 因为我们吃我们进食我们进食的数量呢超过了我们所需要的。
So that will help you to become more determined, and that determination means you'll chant more.
这会使人帮助一个人变得更有决心。这个决心是什么呢？就是他可以念诵更多的宣数。
Do you live to eat, or do you eat to live?
那您活着是为了吃呢，还是说，吃是为了活着呢？
Most people, they live to eat.
大部分人呢，他们活着就是为了吃。
Actually, we should eat to live.
事实上呢，我们应该颠倒过来，我们吃是为了活着，生活。
So the Prabhupada said, the real purpose of fasting is to do more chanting and hearing.
释迦牟尼佛说，戒食的目标是为了使人们更从事更多的聆听和唱诵。
Then you will make spiritual advancement.
之后就可以取得更多的灵性进步。
We don't just simply fast for any material reason.
我们不会仅仅为了物质的理由而去戒食。
We want spiritual benefit.
我们想获得灵性的好处。
And we get that when we chant and hear about Krishna.
当我们念诵 Krishna, 聆听 Krishna 的时候，就会得到灵性的好处。
Understand? I hope. Yeah.
您明白了吗
？Yuvati Vishaka, Madhaji.
Yuvati Vishaka, Madhaji, 您明白理解了吗
？Do more kirtan.
做更多的 kirtan.
Okay, 下一个问题。
Rajendra Prabhu, 顶拜亲爱的 Maharaj, 牧牛姑娘崇拜 Krishna 是最好的。阿蛮为了 Krishna, 放弃家人感受、社会传统习俗，甚至自己的贞洁，我们不能模仿。目前我们灵修还有关注周围环境、他人感受，问题是。如果我们完全放弃感官，不顾及他人的感受，弃绝一切，是否有陷入非人格弃绝的危险呢？如果过度依附感官，过度顾及他人的感受，是否有陷入感官享乐的危险？那又如何平衡呢？Dr. Rajendra Prabhu said, obeisance, dear Maharaj, the gopis worship for Krishna is the best kind of worship.For the sake of Krishna, they give up the feeding of family, they give up the feeding of family members and the traditional social custom, even their chastity. We cannot imitate gopis. For the time being, when we do our spiritual practice, we have to take care of the environment, surrounding in the environment, and we also have to breastfeeding. The problem, the essence is that, the problem is that if we give up our senses completely, if we don't, take care of the feelings of others and we renounce everything, is there any danger that we will involve in the impersonal renunciation? And if we attach to our senses too much, and we consider too much how others feels, and are there any dangers that we will involve in the sense gratification, and how to make balance of the two?
Well, we should not try to imitate the gopis. We want to hear about the gopis, but it doesn't mean we try to imitate them. Maybe you can pray in your next life, you can take birth in the family of the gopis. Now we should understand the gopis, they gave up their husbands and families, but they didn't leave home, they stayed at home. They still were with their husbands. They just gave up the attachment to them in the heart. They still had their children, took care of their children, they did their duties at home. They have to do so many chores, they have different duties, to take care of the cows and milk the cows. They would do all of that. But in their heart was only Krishna. Always thinking of Krishna. So yes, if we try to do these things, then yeah, we will become proud or we'll become hard-hearted.
是的，如果我们努力这么做这些事，努力这么做的话，我们就会变得骄傲，内心变得坚硬。So
one has to come to that stage. That it's a very, but we hear it's the highest stage of devotional service.
这已经是不爱服务的最高境界了。
But we were reading the purports and it was said, even one is ignorant and one has no knowledge and no qualification, we can also get the mercy of Krishna. Just by the mercy of Krishna's devotees, you become qualified for the mercy of Krishna. Sometimes Krishna gives his mercy to even unqualified people. Of course, that doesn't mean we should just be unqualified and wait for Krishna's mercy. No, we should try to attract the mercy of Krishna. By following the principles of Bhakti Yoga.
比如说去追随遵守共爱瑜伽的规范原则。
And especially by hearing and chanting, hearing about Krishna and chanting his names.
特别是通过聆听和唱诵，聆听 Krishna 的，聆听 Krishna， 唱诵 Krishna 的名字。
We want to become more absorbed in the nectar of the holy name, singing the songs about Krishna.
我们希望能够更多的专注于 Krishna 的圣名，专注于歌颂 Krishna。
We don't want to become artificially renounced.
我们不希望变得矫揉造作的气绝。
We see other people, some people, they try to renounce prematurely.
我们看到有人呢试图，就是在还不成熟的做出气绝。
And then they have, then after some time, then they give up.
结果过了段时间，他们就放弃了。
They realize they're not qualified.
他们意识到他们没有资格。
So we have to go step by step. We need to be guided by spiritual teacher, by senior devotees. We have to take their instructions.
所以我们必须是一步一步的进步，我们必须要接受灵性导师和年长奉献者的指导。
We don't just suddenly decide I'm going to be like the gopis.
我们不能忽然就决定我要像那些 gopi 们一样。
No. So we have to be very cautious, go step by step.And take the, follow the teachings of the spiritual master, the founder Acharya, Srila Prabhupada, follow his teachings.
So we have to be very careful, we have to go step by step, and we have to listen to our Dianji teacher, Srila Prabhupada's teaching.
Okay.
下一个问题是书记 Rupa Devdasi 顶拜咕噜在阅读 Vrindavan 的故事中有提到让我们小心脚下的花花草草，因为有可能是 Uddhava 化身的，请问咕噜，这种说法是为了鼓励我们要谦卑，还是真的有可能是 Uddhava 本人呢？Obeisance Guru, when we read about the story of Vrindavan, it is mentioned that we should be very careful about those flowers and the grass under our feet because it is possible that they are the incarnation of Uddhava. The question is that, Guru, is this statement to encourage us to be humble, or is it real that they are Uddhava?Himself.
Well, both are true.
这两种说法都是真实，都是对的。
Certainly, we have to respect all the inhabitants of the Dham, all living entities in the Dham.
我们肯定无疑要尊重 Dham 圣地的所有居民们，所有生物体。
All living entities, all species of life, they're all our brothers and sisters.
所有生物、生命、种族的生命体都是我们的兄弟姐妹们。
Krishna says, Aham Bija Pradapita, I am the seed-giving father, I'm the father of all species of life.
Krishna 说，我是所有，我是给予他们种。种子的所有生物体的父亲。
So the flowers are like our sisters.
那些花儿，他们就像我们的姐妹。
And the rivers and the trees, they're all our family members. We should be very careful.
而那些河流、树木就像我们的家人，所以我们要小心。
And the holy dam is all the property of Lord Krishna. It's none different from Lord Krishna. So we should be very respectful when we come to the dam.
圣地是 Krishna 的财产。他们跟 Krishna 没有什么不同，所以我们当我们去圣地的话，要非常尊敬，怀着尊敬之情。
Okay.
Another. 对于一辈子都去不了稳大问的奉献者，应该如何训练自己，把自己的身体或者居所灵性的像稳大问一样的感恩呢？ For those devotees who can not go to Vrindavan in their life, how can they train themselves that their residence is spiritual life like Vrindavan? Thank you.
There were many great devotees in the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya who did not go to Vrindavan.
在主 Chaitanya 消时光当中，许多伟大的奉献者一辈子都没去过 Vrindavan。
So it's not a disqualification.
这并不是说明他们就缺乏资格。
But we cultivate our spiritual life by hearing and chanting the glories of the Lord.
但是我们是通过聆听唱诵主的荣耀来培养我们的灵性生活的。
So if you're hearing and chanting, and you can also have a nice altar, and you can also have tulsi, and you can do worship of Lord Krishna, so that's none different from the holy dham.
如果您聆听唱诵神的荣耀，并且来就是有一个神坛，你也崇拜图拉西，那么这个崇拜 Krishna， 这跟圣地就是一样的，没什么不同。
Some people go to the holy dham and they just do nonsense. They're just in Maya all the time.
有的人去了圣地呢，在那里胡作非为，他们只是处在 Maya 幻象当中。
But you can be at home and you can be in very good Krishna consciousness.
另外一方面，您可以待在家中，然后去被 Krishna 之觉。
It's not so much the place where you are, but it's the consciousness which you have.
重要的关键不是在哪个地方，关键的重要的是你的知觉。
Yeah.下一个问题。
下一个问题 ，Saraswati Devadasi， Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru， 顶拜您，顶拜主持人和所有的奉献者。Uddhava 认为他没有资格和 Gopi 们联姻，那我们更没有资格了。我该怎么做呢？Hare Krishna， obeisant Guru。Host and all devotees, Uddhava consider that he has no qualification to get association of gopis. And what about us? We have no qualification. Even more. So what should I do?
Well, what you should do is.Associate with devotees.
你应该跟奉献者们联谊。
You don't have qualification to associate with the gopis, but you can associate with other devotees.
您可能没有资格跟 gopi 们联谊，但是你有资格跟其他奉献者们联谊。
Go and associate with the devotees and hear and chant.And one day, gradually, one day, we never know, in the future, we may also become gopis.
跟奉 殿者们联谊、聆听、唱诵，然后在将来的某一天，也许我们自己就成为了一位勾皮。
We have to make the best of whatever situation we're in.
我们可以就是尽最大的可能利用我们自身的现在目前的处的环境。
So you have association. You may not be associated, we're not associating with gopis, but we have association. So that is also good. We're getting association with other devotees. They may not be gopis, they're not on the level of the gopis, but there are many different devotees. Not everybody can be a gopi.
那您可能现在没有资格跟 gopi 们联谊。但是也有别的联谊啊，别的联谊也是很好的呀，可以得到别的奉献者联谊。也许这些奉献者他们并不处在勾饼的层面上，但是也有不同种类的奉献者，他们可能并不是都和勾饼们那样，但是也很好啊。
Uddhava got, he did get some association with the gopis. He got to Vrindavan and he spent some months there with the gopis.
乌德瓦确实他得到了勾皮们的联谊，因为乌德瓦他在文达文去停留了几个月的时间。
But he was being humble, he said, I'm not worthy of the association of the gopis.
但是乌德瓦他出于谦卑，乌德瓦就说，我没有资格得到勾皮们的联谊。
So we should be humble. I'm not worthy to have association with such. But if we get the opportunity, we take it.
We should be humble. We think I'm not worthy to get the opportunity. But if we really have the opportunity, we should grab this opportunity.
Okay.We're getting the association of the gopis by hearing about them. That is association.
我们通过聆听勾皮们的事迹，就得到了勾皮们的联谊。这个也是一种联谊。
We may not associate with them physically, but by hearing about them, that is as good as being with them.
我们可能没有得到勾皮们的亲身联谊，但是我们聆听到了勾皮们的品质，这个就像跟勾皮们联谊一样好。
OK， 下一个问题。
下一个 ，HA， 顶拜敬爱的 Guru 和所有的奉献者，感恩您。昨天是 Ekadasi， 今天要五谷，是五谷破戒，那今天要怎么戒食？那今天要怎么戒食五谷呢？Obeisance, dear Guru and all devotees. Yesterday is Ekadasi. Today we have to break fast by eating grains. So the question is that how can we fast from grain today?
So you just take a small quantity of grain. You see, usually the people who do this, Bhishma Panchak, they will do Nirjal Ekadasi on their Ekadasi. They don't eat and they don't drink. So then the next day, they don't need to take grains to break fast. They can break fast just by drinking water.
那么您可以通过进食少量的五谷来打破戒食。那而在另一方面呢，那些遵守 Bhishma Panchaka 最后五天的奉献者们，他们会做 Nirjala Ekadasi， 就是戒食戒水，他们不吃不喝，然后等到第二天呢，他们是通过进食水喝水来打破头一天的戒食，他们不吃五谷，他们通过喝水打破戒食。
Go ahead.
第二个，我下一个 Yuvati 为 Shaka said, thank you, Gurudev.
OK.
The next one is the 古人顶拜古的莲花族，请问必须吗？安查克戒食可以吃药吗？如果戒食不到五天，可以吗？感恩。
Yes, yes. Do what you can. If you definitely, if you're taking medicine, you should take your medicine. Don't forget your medicine. And yeah, if you can't do 5 days, it's okay. Do what you can.
可以，无论你能够做到哪个地步呢，就去做好了。如果要吃药了的话，那别忘了吃药。如果做不到五天，那就是能做几天，就是遵守几天。
Yes。
下一个是 Sugita Sangha Dasi， 顶拜咕噜莲花族，顶拜所有奉献者莲花族。请问咕噜，此时的牧牛姑娘跟 Krishna 的勾皮们已经不是一样了的吧？此时的牧牛姑娘，Sugita Sangha said obeisance to Lotus feet of Guru and all devotees. The question is that, the gopis nowadays is not the same as the gopis in Krishna's time, right?
Well, some gopis, not all, of course, the gopis today, the people living in Vrindavan who are gopis today, they may not be spiritually on the same level as the gopis in the time of Lord Krishna, of course.
当然，就是当今的gopi在 Vrindavan 的那些gopi们，他们和就是 Krishna 时代的gopi们是不能同日而语的，不在一个层面上。
But because they're residents in the holy dham, they're very special people.
但是因为他们是圣地的居民们，所以他们是特殊的人们。
And if they're just taking care of the cows, that's very special duty. They're very, very special, very pleasing to Lord Krishna.
如果他们履行照料母牛的职责，那么这会非常取悦主 Krishna。
Lord Krishna loves the brahmanas and the cows。
主 Krishna 热爱婆罗门，热爱母牛。
And Lord Krishna spent his childhood growing up taking care of the cows。
Krishna 他的孩提时代，他就把时间就花在照料母牛身上了。
So Krishna has a very deep love for the cows.
Krishna 对于母牛们怀着深深的爱意。
And if somebody is taking care of the cows, then Krishna is very pleased. He's very dear to Krishna.
倘若某人他的职责是照料母牛的话，那么 Krishna 就会非常取悦 Krishna。Krishna 就会非常钟爱这样的奉献者。
Yeah. So, next question.
Yeah, that's all the question for today.
Oh, really? Okay, very good. So, Vaman Ganshya Guru Mani, Ki Vaman Jantai Dafani, Vaman Ganshya Sarada Functions at LinkedIn, Vaman Jufu Niman Chang Song Kwaila, Jira Kwaila.Wan Shi Rui, Chuan Jiao, Shun Li. Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Chan.
Go back to Vrindavan.
No.
Go ahead.
Chan. 我们非常非常感谢 Srila Bhakti Vedanta.